Okay, that's the call coming in on the markets right now, which are looking slightly range-bound this Tuesday morning, you'd have to say. Meanwhile, let's talk earnings as well. You know, we spoke about how we will be touching base with the management of sanitary wear maker HSIL. And just get your quick handle on the numbers before we bring on board the management. In terms of the quarterly performance, you know, we've had a good jump that we've seen in the bottom line. The company posted profits of close to 40 crore rupees versus just 30 crores for the last quarter. We've also seen the operating level performance improve, even as the top line has remained, in fact, a bit softer. So what have been the key drivers that have led to the performance this time round? We've got Mr. R.B. Kabra, president of the company, who joins in to give us more details on the numbers for the quarter gone by. Mr. Kabra, good morning. And like I was saying, you know, even though we've had the top line looking a bit soft, you've still managed to post a robust performance at the, you know, at the margin level. And even on the bottom line, we've had a good jump of about 35% come in. How were you able to do that? Was it, you know, on the back of being able to control costs or were there some other reasons at play as well?
Yeah, ma'am, good morning. You are right. We had a very good year as well as the quarter four ending on 31st March. For the year, if we really see, the gross sale is now 1,965 crore. The PAT is up by 85% to 105 crore. The PBT is up by 56% to 152 crore. And EBITDA was up by 27% to 345 crore. The revenue growth is only 6%, and as you know that we are in two business segments. One is the building products and another is the packaging product. Both the divisions have grown by 6%, and the bottom line improvement has largely come off because of the power and fuel cost control into the glass business. Because as you, I don't know whether you are aware, but last year we had a very bad year for the packaging product, especially for the glass business. And then we worked hard and we substituted the fuel by a cheaper fuel as the power and fuel cost used to be the highest cost in the cost of manufacturing of the glass. And because of this cost control in terms of power and fuel and buying a lot of power not from the grid but through the power exchange, which was the cheaper power, we could control the cost by 8%. And that is how the EBITDA margins in the glass, which has gone to single digit, is now back to 19-20%, which is the sustainable EBITDA margins. And the building products has also maintained its margins in the whole year. The quarter four is a little lower. That is largely because of the high spend by the company on the marketing side. And that you will see that going forward, we will be having a lot of blasts, so making new films and hiring some brand ambassador, all those costs are booked into the quarterly results. But overall, this has been a very good year.
Right, right. Absolutely. Mr. Kabra, in fact, I wanted to break it down in terms of, you know, how the building products division has done and how packaging has done. So first point really is that this is the first quarter where we've seen those cost controls really start to work in favor of the company. Can this continue? And do you think that for, you know, fiscal year 16, these EBITDA levels, the operating level performance of, you know, being close to almost 20% can be maintained? And within these two divisions of building products and packaging, do you think packaging would continue to still see some stress?
No, not really. Actually, to correct you a little bit, the impact of the fuel cost started coming from quarter three of this financial year, which just ended. Quarter one and quarter two, we were at losses at EB at the PBT level in the glass. But we saw the full impact of the conversion to the fuel in quarter three, and quarter three was positive. And quarter four has similarly seen the impact. And since we have now substituted the fuel, which is sustainable over a period of time, so we will be maintaining these margins at EBITDA levels in any case, because whatever convergence has been done for the fuel and power, that is sustainable. Of course, there is a little pressure in terms of revenue growth, because we were expecting growth of 11-12%, but it has only happened 6%. Basically meaning thereby the volume growth is only 3-4% and balance has come out by the product mix and the price increases. This year going forward, we see a good pickup in the glass, and we expect that the glass business would be growing around 12-15%. And maintaining margins, we see again a very good turnaround and better year for the packaging business going forward.
Okay, Mr. Kabra, this is Kamya joining in from Mumbai studio. Would like to know, now you have raised 250 crores via QIP in March. How do you plan to use these proceeds?
Yeah, ma'am, this is, I think we have already given a statement that this money was raised largely to pay off our debts, because our debt levels crossed 1,000 crore rupees. So in this quarter four, in the March 16, when we received the 250 crore for the QIP, everything has been used for paying back the bank loans. And not only this, we have also paid another 100 crore rupees loans from the internal accruals this year. So the total year has seen the reduction in debts to the level of 350 crore, and our interest-bearing debts are now more or less around 700 crore rupees as of March 31st, 15. So whole money has been used for paying of debts, which will see that interest costs going down in the coming quarters.
Mr. Kabra, clearly debt has been brought under significant control. So do you see significant savings on the back of that?
Yeah, because our average interest cost is around 9%. So especially if we see that 350 crore have been paid in this quarter itself, and we will be continue to repaying our debts as per the schedule, which is falling during the coming year as well. So I see that interest costs coming down for the whole year around 25 crore rupees.
All right, Mr. Kabra, we'd leave it on that note. Thank you so much, of course, for joining in and giving us more details on the numbers. That's HSIL management for you. They're expecting a good pickup, especially on the demand front. And along with that, of course, getting those debt levels under control would clearly be reflected on the bottom line, as interest costs also decline for the company. Right now, the stock is a bit soft, but keep in mind, this is a stock that's close to doubled in value in the last year or so. Meanwhile, on that note, we'll take a very quick break on the show. Be back with lots more on the other side.